Hi, this is Burns Hargis here for another edition of Inside OSU, and today we're in the beautiful Noble Research Center, which houses the T. Boone Pickens School of Geology and the Devon Energy Geology Lab. This lab and others are a perfect example of the kinds of corporate partnerships that OSU establishes to provide our students with a great foundation for a successful future and our faculty with the facilities they need to do research and to instruct. Let's go meet some of the real rock stars of OSU. We're inside one of the many labs that Devon is filled with state-of-the-art equipment for our geology program, and with me is the head of the Boone Pickens School of Geology, Jay Gregg, and of course a professor here as well, and this is Patrick Kamen, who's an OSU graduate and a graduate of this School of Geology, correct?
Correct, yep.
Great. Jay, talk a little bit about the general mission of our geology department.
We have a very broad educational mission to teach the students as much as possible about the whole range of geological issues. Once a student moves on to graduate school, which is more or less the professional aspect of the program, the student will be focused more into the areas where we specialize. We specialize in two areas, the first of course being petroleum, which being in Oklahoma, that's reasonable. But the other area that we specialize in and we train students is environmental and water resources.
I see. Talk about the importance of Devon's role in the whole mission of our school.
Well, the donation that Devon made to the Boone Pickens School of Geology was transformative. It just changed the way that we teach, from the smart boards and the equipment that we have. When I was a student here, we didn't have anything like this. And to tell you the truth, I don't think I could go back to teaching the old way with a chalkboard and that kind of thing. Now I need a computer and one of these screens like the one behind you there. And the microscopes that we have for students are just excellent. Some of the other equipment that we have in the laboratories allow the students.
You couldn't do what you do without the equipment that that Devon has provided.
That's right.
Well,
that's right.
One of your products is Patrick Kamen here, who graduated in 2006.
Correct, yes.
And actually works for Devon.
That's right.
Talk about your career here at OSU. Did you go to undergraduate and graduate school?
No, actually, grew up in Ohio. Went to undergrad out there. And I just went to graduate school here at Oklahoma State.
How'd you find Oklahoma State?
Well, it was kind of a coincidence. You know, I was looking online for petroleum schools that focused on the petroleum industry. And Oklahoma State was one of the schools I came across and really enjoyed the faculty when I came out to visit, so I ended up coming out here.
And talk about your training here. I mean, you've actually used all this state-of-the-art equipment.
Yeah, that's correct. You know, Oklahoma State, the T. Boone Pickens School of Geology has some great professors. They give you actual problems in classrooms that I was able to use that knowledge right away going to Devon to look for oil and natural gas.
Tell us about, from your perspective, the importance of this school for Devon and Devon for this school.
Yeah, from my perspective, first off with Devon is committed to giving back to the community in which we operate or our employees live and work. And so giving to Oklahoma State is really a big part of that commitment, whether it's money for labs or money for research or money for students to have scholarships with. That makes the geology program better at Oklahoma State.
And do students intern with
Devon? Yes. Yeah, every year we come into Oklahoma State University and we recruit some students. And that really is key. If we help the university make a better geology program, they make better students and we benefit in the end as well. So it's kind of a win-win for both parties.
Are there a lot of OSU grads at Devon?
Yes, there is. There's quite a few. I couldn't even tell you how many there are. There's probably upwards of 30 or 40 just geologists.
Well, we're going to go see some of this equipment. I know the first time I saw it, it was kind of Star Wars in here, Jay.
Yeah.
As you described it in the old days, it was kind of pick and shovel, and now it's computers and lasers and sensors.
Geology's changed.
It has indeed. Let's go have a look. Well, now we're here in the chemistry lab, and with me is Professor Anna Cruz, a professor in the School of Geology. How are you?
I'm good. How are you today?
Terrific. We've got a lot of high-tech looking stuff around here.
Well, it's a chemistry lab. It should be. See, yeah. Everybody thinks geology is just rocks and hammers and dirt, and it's really not. We do a lot of really high-tech stuff around here.
Devon has provided this equipment.
They have. This is a coulometer. What we use this for is when you have a rock, one of the things that you're interested in terms of its oil and gas potential is how much organic carbon is in it. The rocks that we're really interested in right now that our students are analyzing today are shales, which is, this is a sample of one.
Hmm.
And this rock forms from mud. If you take mud and it's deposited on the bottom of the ocean and it gets buried, you get this kind of rock.
You squish it together.
You squish it and you get a shale.
It's shale.
And it turns out, and you know how it's black.
Geological term.
That's a very fancy geological term. The black color you see is organic matter that started as phytoplankton living in the ocean, and it got buried and it got converted into this organic carbon that's in that rock. And it turns out that that's the primary ingredient for making oil and gas or petroleum.
Now, this is just a small part of the lab,
of the
equipment, rather, that, mm-hmm. That Devon has provided. There's a lot of whiz-bang, state-of-the-art stuff around here.
We have a ton of it in here.
Maybe it's obvious, but what is the real benefit of that to the students?
Our students don't just sit in a classroom and get numbers and read papers, and they actually have to go out and find rocks, they touch them, they have to analyze them, and they're working with the equipment, and they get that real-world experience that they, it's essentially that first day on the job training, but they come out of OSU with that already in place.
Well, let's talk to a couple of these students.
We have a couple who have been running the instrument today, and I'm sure they can show you what it's doing.
Fantastic. Well, here are two students in our School of Geology. We've got Ryder Berriman here. Ryder, nice
good
to
see you.
And Trey Boardman.
Good to see you, sir.
And both of you all are from Stillwater, as I understand it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What attracted you to this School of Geology?
Well, I've always been drawn to science. Never found a niche until I found geology, and the Boone Pickens School of Geology is very well known in geological circles.
How about you, Trey?
Well, I know the Boone Pickens School of Geology has had a long line of oil and gas implements in their students, and oil and gas has been something that's been a very big passion in my life for a long time.
Now, you guys are actually graduate students, right?
Yes, sir.
You both in your first year, is it, of your master's?
First year master's.
Okay. Well, then you've been around this school a long time,
mm-hmm.
and I take it you've gotten the opportunity to work with a lot of the equipment that Devon Energy has provided.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Talk about the benefit of that. I mean, because this is actually used in industry, not just this equipment, but all over these labs, right?
Yeah. Well, this equipment here traditionally would be done by a technician, not a geologist, but being a geologist training on this will help give us insight into interpreting the data that we get from it.
Well, Professor Cruz kind of told us why we use these to, mm-hmm. to figure out how much organic material there is in the,
yes.
in the shale. But tell me exactly how you do that. How does this machine actually work?
Well, it has a furnace, and we heat the sample up to a very high temperature. And we heat the sample, and it releases the carbon, runs through a number of filters.
To turn into a gas?
Yes.
CO2, I guess?
CO2 vapor.
Okay.
Run through a number of filters to remove any other elements that we're not testing for, and is injected into a fluid, and it changes the color, and we actually use a laser to measure the degree of color change.
Which indicates the amount of carbon or organic material and inorganic material,
yes.
right?
Yes.
I've got it. I'm ready for the exam. So when you're, I mean, if a technician does this mm-hmm. in industry, why do you need to know how to do it?
Well, as a geologist, getting to use the equipment that is going to produce data for you will only help you to interpret what data that you're getting.
I see. So, Trey, do you plan on going into industry?
Yes, sir.
Maybe Devon?
That's a big possibility.
There you go. How about you, Ryder? Are you going to end up as a professor, like Professor Cruz?
No, I want to be in the Oklahoma oil and gas industry.
I thought you were going to say Hall of Fame. Well, that's great. Well, we're glad you're here. Thanks for updating us and educating us on this. We thank you very much. That's another edition of Inside OSU. I hope you'll tune in next time, and I hope you've enjoyed seeing the Devon Energy Geology Lab and some real rock stars here. What is this, by the way, Anna?
This. It's an inductively coupled plasma optical emission spectrometer.
Good, good. Well, that's great. Sounds like optical emission spectrometer. No.
This is the one that could really take off.
Oh, boy. Well, let's get with it then. See you next time.